So middle-mile operators really face challenges in a number of different areas. First, for brownfield operators, these are companies who have an existing network, and they need to upgrade that network, expand it, or sometimes even replace it. The challenges there really come into that growth of the core of the network. To facilitate that, it really requires close partnerships with vendors to make sure those vendor roadmaps can help that operator keep up with and even beat the curve of that growth. Another challenge is the pace of activity on these networks. This includes things like circuit adds and NNI upgrades, on-net or even off-net agreements, construction, or even billing. The overarching trend in telecom is this shrinking of the distance between data consumption and data processing. This means that middle-mile networks have a really key part to play, and the key metrics include capacity and latency. For middle-mile operators who are considering deploying greenfield networks, that is brand-new networks, one of the key challenges is finding customers for those networks, whether it be anchor institutions or wireless carriers, as well as forming partnerships with ISPs. This really emphasizes the need for a strong sales team to form those relationships so those services can be delivered and maximize the take rate for such a network. Another challenge for building greenfield networks really is access to right-of-ways. Sometimes right-of-ways may not be immediately available, or they may be out of capacity, and alternative paths may need to be found. Another challenge for greenfield networks can be the state and local guidelines for labor. Unions may be involved here, or there may be requirements to use local contractors for OSP construction. For greenfield networks, the go-to-market model is an important decision, and there's lots of options. These can be everything from owning the fiber duct, but leasing fiber inside of it. You might own the fiber duct and own the fiber, and maybe you lease that dark fiber to other customers. Could be just leasing the duct itself, or leasing just wavelengths on existing service, providing those lit services to the end users. Depending on the go-to-market model that's chosen, the operational support of those customers is also an important challenge. This can include not only the sales team that we talked about already, but maybe design and engineering teams, or construction teams, or even the back office teams for all of those other teams.